listening to an audio article by the Common Constitution. Today's audio article is entitled, Is Tim Scott the Next Gold-Plated Shiny Object for Republicans to Chase? After all, he is the only black Republican U.S. Senator. That's apparently supposed to mean something, despite the fact that we're supposed to be the party of substance, not identity politics. Does no one heed the words of Dr. King anymore? Does no one care about substance over skin color? I didn't fall in love, intellectually speaking, with Thomas Sowell and the late, great Walter Williams because they're black. I couldn't care less if they're black. They are both geniuses in their own right, and Williams was hilarious at times. He is my favorite Limbaugh fill-in host by far. Both are as smart as William Buckley, but don't come off sounding like some aloof erudite douche. They have everyman genius, for want of a better term. And being black had little to nothing to do with anything. But House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy was already sending up the trial balloons prior to Tim Scott's presidential speech rebuttal, saying, quote, can you imagine him on a debate stage with Joe Biden, unquote? No, I can't, Kev, because Biden won't be there by then. And nor would I want to after what Scott said recently. I'll get to that momentarily. The intelligentsia is also pushing Scott. One saying, quote, the noisy and radical voices in the Republican Party are already getting a lot of attention. They need to appeal to more Americans, unquote. Translation, noisy and radical voices are the upstart conservatives who actually stand for something, you know, like the Constitution and Bill of Rights. But sometimes you hear something a man or woman says and conclude, I don't need to know anything more about him or her. Sometime after hearing that one thing, you just know this guy or girl is the wrong choice. And when you hear the word compromise from a Republican or quote, I think we can work with the other side, unquote, you should instinctively know to run the other way. Run as fast as you can away from any Republican today who thinks or says anything even remotely similar. Okay, I've kept you in suspense long enough. On Sunday, May 2nd, Tim Scott was on CBS's Face the Nation. The host was talking about Scott's, quote, efforts to pass some police reform through the Senate, unquote. As an aside, we've had police in this country since 1838, when Boston, Massachusetts established the first full-time police department. Why only now, 183 years later, do we suddenly need police reform? I'm just asking. Here is all I need to know about the Republican senator from South Carolina. Scott says, quote, one of the reasons why I'm hopeful about passing police reform is because, in a way this time, my friends on the left aren't looking for the issue, they're looking for a solution, unquote. That's all I had to hear. No, Senator, your friends on the left are not looking for a solution. They want the issue. They must have the issue to advance their agenda of radical change like defunding and abolishing the current system of policing. Now you might think this awfully short-sighted of me to discount someone merely for a differing viewpoint on one issue. It may be for something other than this. If this were something that had only to do with degrees of something, as we were both interested in moving toward the same goal, then I would agree. If I wanted to cut government spending in half and Scott wanted to start at 15%, then okay. At least we're both heading in the same direction. But this shows me one of two things, and neither is good, neither of which I can support. It shows me that A, he doesn't understand the makeup and goal of the current Democrat Party, autocrats, Marxist or fascist, take your pick. Or B, he does, but is a French Republican, hat tip, Mark Levin, who will always surrender to the Dems by advancing something that's not quite as bad. There is also a C. He actually doesn't believe in anything and will do what the leadership tells him, or worse, that GOP advisors tell him this topic polls well, you know, like Frank Luntz. That's why I will not and can never support another Republican who is not a true, bold, unapologetic, and unabashed conservative, who, like most of us, are sick and tired of compromising with leftists. I'm sure the senator is a good guy, but unless he has a come-to-Jesus moment, I could never support him in a run for the White House. Thank you for listening.